Today on Outside the Box Reviews, we've got ourselves a fight. It's Figure Wars. And here we are looking at Freddy Krueger from the original Nightmare on Elm Street. Classic horror movie villain. And we've got two very unique figures portraying this slasher. On the right here, we have the 2008 Mezco Cinema of Fear Series 2 version of Freddy. And on the left, we have NECA's 2011 release of Freddy. These figures, as I said before, are very different. Very unique takes on the Dream Killer. So, without any further ado, we are going to dive right into these figures piece by piece and see who wins the war. For accessories, Mezco's Freddy has quite a few. We'll start off with the least interesting of all of them. And that's the trash can lid. I mean, it's barely in the movie. Doesn't really do anything all that fantastic. I don't really see the point of this. I think there could have been something better. I would have rather gotten the Freddy phone from the end of the movie. But they felt the need to give us a trash can lid, so who am I to complain? We got a trash can lid. An obvious accessory is, of course, the hat. It's a very hard plastic, but it still fits on his head very well. Has a nice shape to it. Not the most screen-accurate hat, but it works very well with the stylized Freddy we have here. I think it looks really good on him. Despite being hard plastic, it really does fit well. And it kind of adds to the fact that you can't sit it on his head incorrectly. It's also going to sit in the correct position. Some of Freddy's other accessories are kind of hard to fit either an accessory or sculpt, but we're kind of going to split them across the category, since I feel like these are more accessory-type things. Now, both Freddy's have some swappable parts, and I'm going to cover them in the accessory department instead of the sculpt, because they really are Freddy's main accessories. As you can see here on Freddy's sweater, there is a line up at the top, which signifies we could pop this off, and you've got Freddy's bare lower torso. Then we could bring in this different piece of sweater and plug it right in there. As you can see, it covers up a lot of his chest, but you have the green goo from where he cuts himself. And this part pulled up, you can move his hand around and make it look like he's pulling his shirt up. Kind of a neat way to reenact the scene in the film. A clever idea on Mezco's part, I have to admit. Though unfortunately, the paint on this part of the sweater is a bit darker than the rest of the figure, so it is very obviously not the same piece. The last accessory we have here is an alternate left hand. The normal hand is this kind of grabbing-looking hand. Pop that right out. Mezco gave us really nice thick pegs on this, which is great. And replace it with a very similar hand, except he's missing a couple fingers. This, once again, I think is an ambitious move by Mezco, but maybe not the best executed. You can see that it's supposed to be squirting blood out of his two severed fingers. But it really just looks like he has slimy bones coming out of those fingers. Really not the best execution. I know it's hard to get the green slime to look right. Even on the chest, it's this gack green. But it's an interesting idea to include. The cutting of the chest is a little bit iconic in that movie. The cutting of the fingers, I don't feel it's such an iconic moment that you need your action figure to replicate it. However, once again, Mezco could have just given us a figure with no accessories, so it's neat to see what they came up with. NECA is a bit lacking in the accessories, but the ones that Freddy has are very, very nice. Once again, we'll start with the obvious one, being the hat. Now, this is a softer, kind of rubbery plastic, very well detailed, very much accurate to the movie. Basically what you'd expect from a hat from NECA. And it fits on the head very, very well. And you can kind of give it different angles, whatever you want to do. Not that you'd really have Freddy like that, but you could do it if you wanted to. The other main accessory requires some disassembly. We have to take his hands and pop them off. And then we pop off his arms at the shoulder. Then we bring in these bad boys. And then reattach the missing extremities. And now we've got Freddy from the alleyway scene with his long extended arms. I'm counting this in the accessories column because the articulation, sculpt, and paint is fairly consistent with the rest of the figure. So that will tie in with that part of the review. So we're just going to count it here as his kind of extra weapon. And I think it is awesome. I wish I had more room on my shelf where I could display him with his arms fully outstretched like this. Really a cool look for Freddy. Definitely a menacing presence and a great accessory for the figure. I questioned the logic behind some of Mezco's choices. This is full-out iconic Part 1 Freddy. Perfect choice. For sculpt, Mezco definitely went with a very cartoony look for this Freddy. It's kind of their trademark with the Cinema of Fear line. I feel like Cinema of Fear got more realistic as time went on, but they never really escaped that cartoony look. And this Freddy is definitely a classic example of that. The head sculpt has him kind of giving a menacing grin. He has the torn open flesh like he does in the first movie, but it's very big and kind of chunky looking, I guess you can call it. He also is given a hunchback and a kind of elongated neck, which is a little odd. And the sweater is well done. They do a good job of keeping the separate pieces up here in the front looking similar. The hands are pretty well done. They're also a little on the large side. They have some good burn work done on them. Really cool. The glove's a lot of fun. It's big and chunky. Unfortunately, the blades are rounded off, but the blades do look pretty nice. Though the ring finger blade is a little shorter than the rest. I don't know if that's movie accurate or not. You can see the cuts on the underside of the blade. Nicely done. The pants are where I have a problem, because, I mean, the upper parts are okay. It's got a lot of wrinkles in them. It looks kind of weird. Then they come down and they're baggy over his shoes, and it just kind of looks like a skateboarder Freddy instead of a killer Freddy. Still, overall, it's a really nicely done sculpt. And to add to the sculpting, we can pop the head off and put in the torn off skull face. So you can see it's a very similar sculpt to the one they already gave us with the normal head. But it's a very cartoony looking skull. I really don't know how to feel about it, but it fits the overall vibe of the figure. Sculpting on NECA's version is, as always, pretty much as screen accurate as you're gonna get. Really nicely done figure. The head sculpt is spot on. All the tears and burns from the movie are there. The skin actually has a very nice texture to it. The ears are all burnt up and nasty looking. The teeth are just sinister looking. Very well done. It goes down into the neck. Continues on there. The sweater here is actually a separate soft rubber piece, which really surprised me, but it allows better articulation, and I think it actually allows them to use it in future figures a lot easier. So it has all the appropriate wrinkles and such in it. The sleeves don't look like they're off of a different figure. Also very well done. Coming on to the glove, which is phenomenal. Very movie accurate. The Mezco one is cool and chunky. This just looks menacing, sinister. I'm not a huge fan of the pose his hand is in. I kind of would have preferred a more just open hand, ready to strike look. This is kind of more of a I'm gonna get you look. I don't know. And my blade here is bent, even though I could fix that with some hot water. The detailing on the ungloved hand is pretty minimal. There is still some burns there, but it's not overwhelming and not overly cartoony looking. The pants are well done. He shares the same pants with the Part 2 Freddy. And the boots are nicely done too. And as with the Mezco one, you can pop this head off, put on the skull head. This is much more movie accurate than Mezco's one. Very cool though. Very sinister looking. I really, really like this head sculpt. In the paint department, Freddy from Mezco is very, very bright. Almost surprisingly so. They kind of overamped all the colors. His flesh tone is very much flesh tone. The blood and gore is very, very red. As I mentioned before, the green is I mean, heck, that's like gamma green. That could be coming out of the Incredible Hulk. Now, other areas are very weathered. The sweater and... sweater has a nice dark wash over it, as does the glove. The pants are black, but there's nothing really more than that giving it much of an accent. As are the shoes. Actually, it seems like the whole bottom part of this figure is just made of one lump of black plastic. We bring in the skull. Very similar. Very bright flesh tone. Very, very red. Though the muscles and tendons on the face do look pretty nice. It's definitely a colorful Freddy. And with the style that Mezco did, it works. It does work. It's just not really movie accurate, but it works. NECA went the opposite direction. The skin tone is very subdued and burned looking and dirty. The sweater as well, very dirty and grimy looking. The pants, though, kind of still suffer the same problem. They're just kind of black. I think there's a little bit of a gray wash on them, but not a whole lot extra. The glove is done pretty well. The red up here is a little bright. I think they went a little too far with the brass copper look. They actually had this a little different on the Part 2 figure. I think it looks a little nicer. If you want movie accurate paint, NECA's definitely the way to go. It's not as overdone as the Mezco by far. It looks really, really good. As with their skull head, you could see it has much more of a bone color to the face and some bloody color around it. The eyes are really well done as well. For articulation, the Mezco one has quite a bit. He has a ball-jointed neck. I believe they are ball-jointed shoulders. You get total 360 and then in and out. Although they don't go in very far, and without any kind of bicep joint, the arms kind of end up being quite far away from the body in their lowest pose. Bend at the elbow. This wrist is a ball joint, giving you a good range of motion out of the glove. This wrist is a swivel and hinge, once again giving a great amount of rotation out of the hand. He can rotate at the waist, and it's not all that hindered by his sweater, which is pretty nice. And then from the waist down, he is one solid piece. For NECA, he has a ball jointed head, pin socket shoulders with a great range of articulation. You can bend and pivot at the elbow, ball-jointed wrists on both hands. He is kind of a mid-torso joint with this rubbery sweater. It's able to move as though it was a normal waist joint, but it actually sits right about here. Gives him a really nice range of articulation. And then he also has ball-jointed feet. As I mentioned earlier, his extra arms share the same articulation. Now, who is the winner? In the last figure wars between the two Jason figures, I thought it was really easy to name the winner. I mean, it was so obvious that NECA went above and beyond what Mezco even attempted to do. In this case, I think intent is a big part of it. Simply, I don't think Mezco is trying to make a movie-accurate figure. I don't even think Mezco is trying to make a figure that looked like Robert Englund. I believe they were trying to make a Freddy that had the costume elements of Part 1, and had some cool accessories from some memorable scenes in the movie, without worrying about things that actually existed in the behind-the-scenes world. Their Freddy was a cool little stylized thing, and I could almost see him being a character in a video game or something to that extent. NECA obviously went the complete opposite direction. They wanted a Robert Englund likeness, they wanted everything to be as movie-accurate as they could get it. And they accomplished that too. And I feel like both of these figures did what they set out to do. They both have pretty good articulation. They both have good accessories. They're both painted fairly well, sculpted fairly well. So, I don't know. I really want to say NECA's the winner, because when it comes down to it, it is a Part 1 Nightmare on Elm Street Freddy Krueger figure. In that movie, it was Robert Englund, and he looked like this in the makeup. So, by the narrowest of margins on that detail, I have to say NECA wins, but I'm going to keep both these guys on my shelf. With my remake Jasons, my NECA figure stands in front of the Mezco one. The Mezco one is there, but not visible. In this case, I'm going to keep both these guys visible. I'm going to have the NECA figure as the definitive look of Freddy Krueger in that movie. I'm going to have the Mezco one behind him in damage mode. I'm going to have him kind of like this, with the shirt pulled up, the skeleton face on. I might even put the blood-spurting hand on him. I think it's a cool contrast, and especially because the likeness isn't all that great. If you put him in the skull face and have him kind of obscuring himself, it works all the more better. And slightly in the background, some of these details that are pretty glaringly noticeably not movie accurate now fade into a bit of obscurity. So when it comes down to it, I really like both these figures. I would recommend both of these figures. The NECA one, currently, would be pretty easy to pick up. I know most Toys R Us's and maybe a comic book store or two probably still have them on the shelves. The Mezco one, I bought him in 2008, and he was long gone then. I probably paid the most I've paid for any of the Mezco figures for this one. And he was a hard one to track down. And I got him new off of Amazon for a bit of a premium. But I think he was worth it. And until a few months ago, he was the best 7-inch Part 1 Freddy I've seen. I honestly am not a fan of the McFarlane one. I guess I could have gotten my hands on one of those and brought it for a 3-way fight here, but I didn't feel that was necessary. When it comes down to it, both figures are very fun and entertaining representations of the character of Freddy Krueger. But I want to hear what you guys think. So comment below. Which one do you think is the winner? Do you think Mezco's stylized version is the coolest? Or are you more of a fan of NECA's straight-off-the-screen version? Just let me know in the comments below. Or better yet, if you've got both of these, do your own review and put it as a video response. So that is it for our third installment of Figure Wars. Stay tuned for more reviews to come.